Yo, what's good, guys? We are back from vacation. I know it's been about 2 weeks since you last saw me. I'm going to be working a lot on my car now that I'm home for the summer. We're going to be doing a little DIY project here today, so I'm going to bring you guys along. I hope you guys enjoy.
All right, so first step of this, we're going to jack the car up and get the wheels off.
All right, so to get your wheel off, you're going to need a 17 millimeter socket and a wrench, obviously.
Alright, so don't be dumb and forget to loosen the wheel bolts before you jack it up and put it on jack stands like me. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. Obviously you do the same thing for the rear, but I'm going to skip that because I don't want this video to be too long. Alright, now we got all the bolts loose, we're going to jack it up and throw it on jack stands so we get these wheels off.
Alright, so this is what we're going to be doing today. Obviously it's all dirty in here, I'm going to clean these up. But this right here is all rusted. And when my car's clean, it just sticks out like a sore thumb. So we're going to go ahead and paint that black.
Sorry it's a little bit windy out here today, I hope you guys can hear me okay. I'm going to go ahead and clean my calipers right now, just so once I'm finished painting the where all the rust is, it looks really nice. Doesn't reach all the way over here, so here's my brilliant alternative to rinsing them off. While that dries, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing to the back caliper, get it nice and clean. Alright, so both the front and the back calipers are done on this side. I'm just going to let them sit and dry for a few minutes just so that there's no moisture around the area that can mess up anything that I'm doing in the future.
Okay, so what I'm going to be doing now is I'm going to be taping off this entire rotor with painter's tape just because you don't want any of the things that you're going to be using to touch that. That could really mess up your car. If you're going to do this, really tape it up well. Make sure nothing can get on there just so you can get around here. So I have 3M blue painter's tape that I'm going to be using for this part. I think it works really well, so that's what I'm going to be using. You can overlap as much as you want, just make sure you get the entire rotor. It's better to have more than less. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this up really quick, and I'll see you guys when I'm done.
Alright, so first thing I'm going to be doing now that I have it all masked off, I'm going to be spraying it with Metal Prep Rust Remover and Pre-Primer. You spray this on, leave it on for about 20 minutes, and then you rinse it off. So here we go. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and let that sit for about 20 minutes and I'll be back when it's done. Okay, so I let this soak for about 20 minutes. Now I'm going to rinse it off. Alright, now that that's rinsed, I'm going to let it dry. I'm going to dry it with my towels and wait for it to be completely bone dry because that's what the instructions say and I don't want to mess this up. Alright, so I dried this with my towel, but I want to make sure it's really dry, so I'm going to let it air dry for a little bit. I'm going to head to the back, start taping that off while I wait. Alright guys, so we're going to go ahead and throw down a coat of primer right now. Just a really light coat is all you really need. So I'm going to leave this part right here in between the caliper, just because I've gotten them painted and I don't really want to mess that up. So you really can't see it unless you're staring right at it with the wheel off. So I'm just going to leave that there and let it dry for now.
Alright, so this is what it's looking like with just the primer on right now. So we're going to go and let that sit for about 3 hours, let it dry before we put the base coat on.
Alright, so since we're clearing up that area, cleaning it up really nice, making it look good, I decided we're going to go ahead and clean the BBS. So I'm going to be using Dub Wheel Cleaner. You've seen me use this before in another video. You just spray it on there, it gets all the dirt loose and everything like that. While we let that sit, we're going to fill up our bucket with some Mother's California Gold car wash, just normal, no wax. We're also going to clean out our wash mitt and wash pads because I used them on the brakes earlier and they're pretty dirty. Alright, so I want to show you guys something. You saw that it went on, it was green like it is right there. Then we'll go around to the back. It's this reddish purple. So when you see that change colors, that's good. It means it's working. It's pulling up all the dirt and stuff like that. So that's good. All right, it is the next day. I let these dry overnight. I still have to clean up the rotors a little bit, but I don't want to wash those yet just because I want the paint to be completely dry. So this is what it's looking like right now. I'm going to do a before and after at the end here. Just, it's miles and miles better. So that's what it's looking like now. I'm going to clean up the rotors. There's a little like adhesive stuff on there from the tape, but I'm going to wash that right off once this dries completely. To my grave, there's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway. And if you have nightmares, we'll dance on the bed. I know that you love me, even when I lose my head. Guillotine, bum ba dim bum bum booty, bum ba dim bum bum booty. Guillotine, bum ba dim bum bum, even when I lose my head.